income, consumption curve, normal good and inferior good, part 2. Already I discussed the derivation of income consumption curve in my previous video. For the benefit of those who didn't watch, I have given the link in the description. My previous video ends like this. In our diagram, income consumption curve is sloping upwards. This normally is the case. We shall start from where we finished. Yes, normally the income consumption curve slopes upwards. When the two goods are normal goods, the income consumption curve will slope upwards. But what is a normal good? You will learn subsequently. But this is not the case always. It may take different shapes. On the basis of the shapes, economists classify goods as normal, inferior, necessary, luxury, and neutral. We shall see them in some detail in this lesson and in the lessons that follow. Good X is measured along the X-axis and good Y along the Y-axis. Price lines P1, L1, P2, L2, P3, L3 and P4, L4 represent income levels 1000 rupees, 2000 rupees, 3000 rupees and 4000 rupees respectively. They are all parallel to one another. It signifies there is no change in the prices of two goods. E1, E2, E3 and E4 are the equilibrium points at various levels of income. By joining all the equilibrium points, we obtain income consumption curve. The curve is not sloping upwards throughout its length as we have already seen. The income consumption curve here bends backward. As income consumption curve traces the income effect, we shall examine the quantities purchased by the consumer. We shall start with good Y. When the income is 1000 rupees, he buys 25 units of good Y. He buys 50, 150 and 250 units at income levels 2000 rupees, 3000 rupees and 4000 rupees. As his income increases, he buys more. In case of good Y, there is positive relation between income and quantity. A good whose quantity demanded is positively related to income is called normal good. In our discussion, good Y is a normal good. What about his purchase of good X? He buys 150 units when his income is 1000 rupees. He increases his purchase to 200 units when his income increases to 2000 rupees. Beyond that, he reduces his demand. He buys 100 units when his income increases to 3000 rupees. At 4000 rupees income, he buys even less. He buys only 50 units. Beyond income level 2000, there is negative relation between income and the demand for good X. As the consumer reduces his purchase with every increase in income beyond 2000, good X is inferior in this range. Inferior good is one for which there is negative relation between income and quantity demanded. What is to be noted here is, when inferior good, good X is represented along the X-axis and normal good, good Y along the Y-axis, the shape of the income consumption curve is backward bending towards Y-axis. You must understand, there is positive relation between income and quantity demanded for good X in the low range of income, that is 1000 rupees to 2000 rupees. In this range, good X is a normal good. Beyond that, it becomes an inferior good. Here, I must give an example. At a very low level of income, poor people consume bajra. In the early stage, they buy more bajra with every increase in income. But once their income crossed a certain limit, they switched to wheat, which in their view is superior to bajra. They divert more money from bajra to wheat. Naturally, they buy less bajra as their income increases. Bajra becomes an inferior good. This doesn't mean bajra is an inferior good in absolute terms. IC analysis doesn't do that. For that matter, it never says specifically these are normal goods and these are inferior goods by naming the goods. It says only when the income exceeds a certain limit, some goods become inferior. Normal good or inferior good, it all depends on the income range, assuming the prices of goods remain constant. We shall end our discussion with this. We shall meet again to discuss when an income consumption curve takes a downward bending towards x-axis.